Cumberland Gap, Cumberland Gap, way down yonder in the Cumberland Gap. Cumberland Gap, Cumberland Gap, way down yonder in the Cumberland Gap. Oh, the Cumberland Gap, cliffs and rocks, home of a panther, the bear and the fox. Oh, the Cumberland Gap, with its cliffs and rocks, home of the panther and the bear and the fox. Oh. A mighty fine place, three kinds of water to wash your face. Lay down, boys, take a little nap. 14 miles to the Cumberland Gap. Oh, Cumberland Gap, Cumberland Gap. Yes, the Cumberland Gap. Hi there, Dr. Dennis with Bluegrass Ukulele Celebration, and we're going to be talking today about a historic based folk song that is called the Cumberland Gap. As we know that when Europeans began to arrive to settle in the New World on the coast of the not yet United States of America, the East Coast, they had a natural barrier where they couldn't go westward. The barrier was the Appalachian mountain range. And after examining some of the different alternative routes, there was one natural place, the Cumberland Gap, that opened up that you could go through without it being too treacherous by way of an obstruction of a mountain. This is a place right today, which is where three states come together, Tennessee, Virginia, and Kentucky. A beautiful mural has been painted in honor of this trek called the Cumberland Gap, and central in it is Daniel Boone, who did lead these people through to what is now probably the very eastern portion of what we call the Midwest, which really, for most of us, we don't even think of it being something like that. Nonetheless, that was the route that they took. Now, what was their motivation? Well, part of it was free land, but also another motivation was that King George, that was the sovereign over the 13 colonies in America, was unwisely taxing people without representation, getting an awful lot of people angry, and so they didn't want to pay taxes to King George, and also they wanted to acquire their own plot of land and start their own farm out what was then considered a little bit more west of where they were. Now, interestingly enough, the Cumberland Gap, in this particular arrangement, which was adapted from five-string banjo and bluegrass style, is quite simple. In the ukulele world, right now when I play this wide open in this tuning, I'm playing a C chord automatically. When I come down in this chord, right here, I'm playing an A minor, and in this case I'm playing a G7. You see, these are extremely simple chords. Here's one chord, here's another chord, and there's another chord. Very easy. But in order to embellish the sound of Cumberland Gap, we move up the neck with a movable chord. If you have a chord like a B flat, because it covers all the strings, you can move up the neck with it, or a bar chord, do the same, or with a G chord, or G shape, you can move up the neck. In this particular case, I'm moving up the neck. I'm not going to tell you the name of the chord. That's getting a little bit too complex, but a lot of times bluegrass will try to bring in some simple modified sounds that are rather sometimes discordant and sometimes very pleasant to listen to. So here we are with down the neck. This is down the neck because it's down in pitch. Here we are up the neck, moving toward the head of the banjo-lele, which is up in pitch. So we talk this down the neck, up the neck. Let me play it through. You watch my hands. Mm-hmm. neck. Cumberland Gap, Cumberland Gap, way down yonder in the Cumberland Gap. The history of a people is very often a history which is recorded in song, and Cumberland Gap is an excellent example of this. We'll see you next time.